Greetings from the Kennedy Space Center, Florida. A couple of days ago, I've learned that there will be a rocket launch. SpaceX is launching Falcon 9, I believe, and I simply could not pass up the opportunity to see it with my own eyes. The bus is currently taking us to the prime viewing location adjacent to the Apollo Saturn V Center, and it is about 4 miles, 6 kilometers from the launch pad. That huge cube building that you can see is the biggest one-story building in the world. It's an assembly place where they assemble the rocket and put them in specialized vehicles and take them slowly to the launch pad.
1 minute.
When you look in the middle of the screen, you will see in the distance the tiny rocket. Actually, it's not so tiny, but since we are 6 kilometers as the crow flies from the launch pad, it looks tiny. And you may notice the plumes, what looks like smoke coming off the rocket. And it's actually just liquid oxygen vaporizing, boiling off as it comes in contact with air.
After second engine cutoff and confirmation of deployment on social, and we'll confirm deployment of the satellites on social once we regain coverage at about the T+1 hour and 20 minute mark. Weather is currently a watch item, but the latest weather forecast shows about 80% favorability for liftoff. With that, the vehicle, satellites, and range are also looking good for an on-time liftoff just a few minutes from now. Today will be our 144th launch of a Falcon rocket. And on screen, you're looking at a live view of our vertical Falcon 9 rocket at Launch Complex 39A at Kennedy Space Center in Florida. The first stage booster for this mission is flying for the sixth time. It previously supported NASA's Crew 1 and Crew 2 missions, Sirius XM-8, NASA Commercial Respawn Mission 23, and most recently the IXPE mission at the end of last year. That first stage will accelerate the second stage and our Starlink satellites through the Earth's atmosphere and then separate to make its way back down to Earth. There are 9 Merlin 1D engines at the bottom of the first stage, and fun fact, Falcon 9 is named not only after those 9 engines, but also after the Millennium Falcon from Star Wars. When those 9 engines power up, they'll deliver a thrust roughly equal to 7 747 airplanes taking off at the same time.
And we've stopped the clock, standing by to find out what we have happened here.
So this is it for today. I hope you liked the video and see you next time. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye bye.